नमस्कार तुमका सगळ्यांक पेंट ब्रश या कार्यावळीक येवकार हांव नागेशराव सरदेसाय प्रसाद पानकार हो गोंयचो फामाद फोटोग्राफर आनी फोटोग्राफी टिचर ताजे CMYK अकॅडमींतल्यान अनेक भुरगे अनेक स्टुडंट्स भायर आयिल्ले आसात आनी दरेक दुसरो भुरगो जो फोटोग्राफी करता तो ताजेच अकॅडमींतल्यान भायर सरला हें म्हणपाक दुबाव ना ताजें एग्जिबिशन ताणें दवरिल्लें आसा हें सगळें भुरग्यांचें ताजें नांव मेमोरेबलिया अशें दवरलां म्हणजे आपल्या आवय आनी बापायच्या यादीन हें एग्जिबिशन ताणें केल्लें आसा दीस इज द फस्ट क्युरेटेड एग्जिबिशन ऑफ फोटोग्राफी आमचे बरोबर आसा सेलेब्रेटेड फोटोग्राफर आनी फोटोग्राफी टिचर प्रसाद बाब पानकार प्रसाद बाब वेलकम टू द शो
थँक्यू सो मच
म्हाका सांग हें मेमोरेबलिया आनी हें एग्जिबिशन तुमचे स्टुडंट्स आनी तुमचे हें एग्जिबिशन इन द मेमरी ऑफ युअर पेरंट्स
हें कितें दीस एग्जिबिशन इज व्हेरी व्हेरी क्लोज टू माय हार्ट अँड इट्स अ व्हेरी इमोशनल इव्हेंट फॉर मी इट इज बिकॉज इट इज इन द मेमरी ऑफ माय पेरंट्स हुम आय वॉज व्हेरी क्लोज टू अँड आय ऑलवेज ऑलवेज वॉन्टेड टू समथिंग इन द मेमरी अँड नथिंग कॅन बी बेटर दॅन फ्रॉम द वर्क्स ऑफ माय चिल्ड्रन एज यू सेड माय स्टुडंट्स ओके हु हॅज डन फॅन्टास्टिक जॉब अँड सपोर्टेड मी सो मच इन द प्रेझन्स ऑफ माय टिचर माय फोटोग्राफी गुरु मिस्टर विजय नायक हु वॉज देअर एट द एग्जिबिशन ॲट द हँड्स ऑफ द पर्सन हुम आय ऑलवेज ॲडमायर्ड at the hands of the person whom I've been following for the last 25 years and the person who had done so much for Goa, Remo Fernandez, okay, who needs no introduction to the world.
Yeah, definitely.
And having said this, my wife was there yesterday, my children were there yesterday, my sisters had come down, especially one sister had come from Belgium, okay. Especially for this occasion. The people who had been with me since my journey started, okay, they all were there yesterday and it was a very memorable day and it was a fantastic thing. Now having said all this, if you see the exhibition, I've not given a particular theme. It is only because I wanted to show the talent of my students who are working in different genres of photography. Like you will see fashion photography there, you will see a portrait over there, you will see tabletop, then wildlife, birds photography, nature photography, landscape, candidates, different things are there, art photography, okay? So what happens if I give a theme, then all this talent are hidden.
Okay.
I can't bring out this talent in same way, okay? Okay? Right. That is the reason why I didn't give them anything.
But how many works were on display? Because it was a very huge exhibition. I could actually see that it was a crowd of beautiful photographs, of talented photographers so showing their works. And it was like an eclectic mix. There were a lot of other genres which were displayed. So how many photographers were there? How many of them have submitted? And how much you had to struggle to select them?
Okay, I'll tell you all this. Yeah. Around 100 photographers submitted their work and total pictures which I received was around 1,000.
Oh.
So you can imagine what I must have gone through.
Okay.
And I had given them strict instructions. The pictures on merit will go on the wall. The maximum pictures per photographer were 3. Okay. If I told them, if I like all 3 pictures, all 3 will go on the wall.
Okay.
If I didn't like any of the pictures, nothing will go on the wall. Okay. So I had told them, because we came over in the gallery and we told them the number of pictures I will go 150 we decided number.
Okay.
It was pre-decided number.
Okay.
150.
You all had decided.
Yes.
Okay.
Work hard to be
selected in that.
Yeah, we in the 150.
Okay.
Okay. So it becomes a challenge.
Yeah, okay? That's true.
I understand those works which are not selected of the they will work hard for the next year.
They will be dejected.
I'm sure.
Because this was a massive exhibition.
They will be dejected. Massive exhibition, important event. I'm so sure they will be dejected. But I told them if not selected, no problem. You work hard and be in 150 next year. And as I said earlier, the works were really fantastic. I had tough time, but I was very harsh and very, very, very stiff on them.
All of these photographers are your students.
All.
And they range from what is the age that age
the youngest one right now is 8 years old.
Oh, my own 8 daughter, years old. 8 okay. Years old. Okay.
She was 7 when she started.
Okay.
Okay. Then there is one 9 year old. Mm-hmm. There is a 10 years old.
Okay.
260 plus.
Okay.
Yeah.
So this is a huge range for talent to be displayed.
Absolutely.
And how do you think they stand in terms of their age? Because if an 8-year-old starts photographing and if she displays, then she's competing with somebody who is 80 years of 60 or 70 years old. And how is that talent you can gauge?
It's a very good question. Because you being an artist and you being an art teacher, you will agree to what I'm going to say next.
Yeah.
Because in art, age is just a number.
Yeah, that's true.
Correct?
Yeah.
Because if you...
Talent is ageless.
Yes. Yeah. It's ageless. Okay. An 8-year-old girl can compete with 50 plus, 60 plus.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, only what will vary is the thought behind in the picture.
Yeah, exactly.
That will be the only criteria.
Yeah. Yeah.
But technique and other things are concerned, I don't think there should be a problem.
That, that requires, that does
the
not
maturity
require age.
The work will come as per the age.
Yeah, yeah. Yes, and as per the experience as well.
Yes.
But and sometimes you have some inborn talent.
Yes, inborn
which
talent.
Gets translated into good pictures.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Okay. Mm-hmm. So, only thing with the philosophical paintings, philosophical
conceptual
picture will come of age.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. But otherwise, I think age is just a number as long as art is concerned.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that is true. Anik, you have been teaching art for so long. What is the time frame now you have been teaching art and this CMYK Academy, which I think
exactly
is a premier institute in Goa.
Yeah.
So what is that? Tell us about that, the inception of it and how you started, why you started.
Yeah. Well, okay. In 2003, I gave up my job.
Because you started as a photographer.
I started as
you
a photographer.
Didn't start as a photography teacher.
No.
So how did that happen?
Yeah.
Why did you feel like you should have competition?
No, I never thought like they have a competition.
Yeah.
If any artist who thinks of a competition, then he will not last forever. Because I like competition because it keeps me on my toes, and competition gets the best out of me. Otherwise, as a person, as an artist, I will never would have improved. Okay. Coming back to CMYK, why I started it. Before 2007, I've had around 17 exhibitions.
Okay.
Yeah.
That is one man show.
Yeah.
Then your own.
My okay. Before I could start teaching.
Yeah.
And every exhibition, let me tell you, sir, people used to come walk up to me and say, "Do you teach photography?"
Okay.
So do you teach photography? And I
so
said,
they were thirsty of learning from
learning.
You.
Yeah.
Probably because they saw your
something
pictures
in my pictures, and then they wanted to learn this art. I said, maybe I will learn when I grow gray and fat with the pot belly.
Okay.
Probably I will start teaching you.
Okay.
You know, and it went like this.
Okay.
But towards the end, the pressure was too much.
Okay.
And the institute which means where I learned from, that person had moved out of Goa.
Okay.
So there was a void created.
Okay.
Okay.
Where was that?
Sanodek.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. There was a void created and the pressure was too much. People came up to me, started teaching. And I said, why not? Okay. I always believe in one thing. If you learn something, you keep.
Yeah, that's true.
Because you have got it from somebody.
Yeah.
Nobody in this world has got the thing from mother's womb.
That's true.
Okay. But again, if you do not share your knowledge, you stagnate.
Yeah, that's
true. You do not grow as a person.
Yeah.
You do not grow as an artist.
Exactly.
Then I thought it's a wonderful idea.
And knowledge, Mantat, we say that knowledge grows when you share.
Yeah, and another thing I would like to tell your viewers is that in mind, is because art is lot of to do with mind. A lot of to do with philosophical thoughts.
Okay.
I strongly believe this. When you give away your talent, when you give away, share your knowledge, a space is created in your mind for fresh ideas.
Yeah, yeah, that's true.
But okay, being an artist, you will understand what I'm telling you. A space is created in your mind for new ideas, for new talent. Otherwise, you get stagnated.
Bravo.
Okay, and I started teaching for this simple ideology is to spread the art and love of photography. And it all began in 2007. And I never ever thought that I would my academy would be so successful. And I thought about more than 1,000 people. And they're all around the globe. You call it in West Indies, in Australia, they're in Gulf, because we go and say everywhere.
Yeah.
And plus, the travelers would come to Goa. They've learned from me and they're happily gone out.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you have never feared that you will be... You will have competitions too.
Never. If I never would have started teaching.
That's true.
Never.
Okay.
Correct.
How did trigger in so you that you should start photography?
I was always interested in photography since my childhood, and then I did my commerce. I got a job in the bank. Okay, but at that time, you know, as I was growing up, to get a camera was so difficult. Okay, either you had to have someone in the abroad. Mm-hmm. Or because now when you buy a camera over the counter, yeah, things were
yeah.
not like that.
Yeah, yeah, I know.
Okay, and being the only son, I could ask for anything, I would get it.
Yeah.
Somehow
yeah.
accept the camera.
Okay.
But looking back, I think that was a boon because the love for photography mm-hmm. remained like a dormant volcano inside me.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. And I did my course at Standard Tech. Mm-hmm. It was a weekend course, Sunday course. I met my guru Vijay.
From mathematics and numbers and arithmetics yeah. to photography.
Yeah,
okay,
yeah.
fine.
And I met my other teacher, Aliri Saldana.
Okay.
So it was during the course that the volcano which was there, mm-hmm. it erupted.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and that's when I knew what was my calling. So then in 2003, I quit my banking. Okay. And
you were working in a bank.
I was working in a bank. Mm-hmm. Okay. And after marriage, my wife gifted me my first camera.
Oh.
I started working side by side, mm-hmm. taking work. People started appreciating my photographs.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Then I started taking
work. You took the risk of quitting your bank job.
Yes, yes, yes.
That was great.
Yeah.
I mean, you had so much of faith in your yeah. passion.
Correct. And you will not believe it. I quit my bank. I took BRS. Mm-hmm. And the first child was born.
Oh.
Yes.
That was more risky.
Yeah, very risky yeah. situation. Yeah. And my wife supported me very, very well. Otherwise, you know, things wouldn't have been different.
Okay.
Would have been
yeah,
different.
Definitely.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
We wouldn't have Prasad Pankar and we wouldn't yeah, have yeah. CMYK.
Correct. Okay.
And we wouldn't have this talent who
exactly
could show their
work. So I left my bank. It was like the first day without bank, it was like there was no umber on top. Mm. There's no dirty below.
Yeah, yeah.
Like,
yeah,
no, they
yeah.
say
yeah.
the
same
thing. So, and from one thing led to another. Then slowly I started my getting orders. Then Sapna Sar Desai, you must know. She gave my first print break when I was still in the bank.
Okay.
Yeah. And one thing led to another. Soon I was starting working for shooting for Femina. I met Ethel. With her, I started working for Femina. Then one thing led to another. Started getting assignment by assignment. Then came the Fontaine's Festival.
Yeah.
My first turning point.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Then came the exhibition where I got the recognition. I displayed my work over there. So then I started exhibiting work. So I've had 16, 17 successful exhibitions. And the last was
I mean, you had one-man shows for
yeah,
so long.
One-man
okay.
show, group shows.
Okay.
The last exhibition was in Lisbon,
okay.
Portugal. Yeah.
Okay.
Then one thing was sure. When I left my bank, I knew I would get into fashion photography.
Okay.
I had my goal over there
okay.
very strongly.
You wanted to be
yes,
a fashion
yes,
photographer.
Yes, yes. That was so because I'm very much fascinated by human form.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, because that's my fascination. I see human form is a gift of God. Yes, and second thing I like, of course, I started with nature as any artist would.
Yeah.
I love nature. I'm very close to nature, and being in Goa, it's
you can't run away from it. Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Even if you run away from it, you run back to nature.
Back to nature.